So today's class is a little bit different from the previous weeks. We're going to be, with your mats, after your sun salutations, you might be better setting yourself up long ways to the screen so you can see, but we'll make sure we face the same way each time. So as long as you can see out from your mat, the screen, long ways, that's absolutely fine. But from this, let me start again. We'll just begin with a quick warm up. So find yourself in the center of your mat, find yourself in Tadasana, and we'll just begin with a bit of grounding. So lift the toes, spread them, really feel the ground underneath your feet, really press your feet into the ground. Think about engaging through the legs, tucking the tailbone under, rolling those shoulders back and down, sucking the navel in, and then lengthening through the crown of the head. And when you're ready, just take a nice deep breath all the way in. Exhale, let the shoulders melt away from your ears. Two more deep breaths, all the way in. Exhale. One more, all the way in. And exhale again. So from here, we'll just begin by rolling our shoulders back and down. Maybe five or so times backwards. Again, noticing how they feel, noticing how the shoulder blades slide down the back. Notice how your body moves. And then when you've done five or so times backwards, come back to center and then go forwards. Five or so times forwards. One more time all the way around and then come back to center. From here, we're going to inhale as we lift our right arm up, reaching up tall, stretch through the side body, and then exhale as you reach all the way over to the left. Inhale, back to center, switching over the arms. Exhale, reach all the way over to the opposite side. We're just going to do three of these, moving with your own breath, in your own time. Really lift and reach through that midline. And when you exhale to fold, just go as far as you feel uncomfortable. So you should feel a stretch. Last one each way. And then this time, take the arms out wide. We're gonna wrap the arms around the body as we twist to look behind. Again, lifting and lengthening as you come through that midline. Think about lifting your spine out of your pelvis, like it's a peg in a hole. You're gonna lift it up as you come through that center line, and then let it wrap, let your arms wrap around your body. One more each way. And then come all the way back to center. From here, we're just going to soften the knees. Inhale as you lift the hands all the way up. Exhale as you come all the way down into your Uttanasana forward fold. So from here, don't worry about having straight legs. Think about bending the knees and rather getting your chest over your thighs, crown of the head towards the floor. You can leave your hands on the floor or take opposite hand to opposite elbow. And just gently rock out from side to side in that ragdoll variation. Taking a few deep breaths. Really focusing on kind of elongating through the back, drawing that tummy deeper over those legs. And then exhale, place the hands on the floor. From here, we're just going to do three crouch curls. So lifting your heels off the floor, coming down into the bottom of your squat, knees to chest, nose to knees, and then exhale as you push up and back, focusing on opening out the backs of those legs. Inhale to crouch. Exhale to fold. Last one, inhale to crouch. Exhale to fold. Inhale, come all the way up, extend to Tadasana, reaching up tall, and then exhale, release the arms and come back to your regular Tadasana. We're gonna interlace the fingers, clasp the hands together and churn the wrists. While you're churning the wrists, we're going to move onto one leg, and you can either rotate the ankle like so, or you can place top of toe onto the floor and churn through the ankles like so. We're going to do 10 or so rotations on each foot whilst churning the wrists the whole time. So I'm going to do maybe three or four more on this foot, and then switch sides. And go onto the other foot. So again, you've got those two options. The second option is slightly more uncomfortable, but we'll get into all the toes, the tops of the feet, as well as just the ankles. And it might throw you off with the churning as you're going around. Just do a couple more rotations on that leg, and then relax and come back to Tadasana at the front of your mat. So finding yourself again in that Tadasana position, just like the start, set yourself up. And when you're ready, take a nice deep breath in, exhale, and we'll begin with our sun salutations. So we're going to inhale as we lift the hands up, reaching up tall, extended Tadasana. As we exhale, we're going to hinge at the hips, coming all the way down into our Uttanasana, forward fold. Take a nice deep breath in, find length in the spine. Exhale, fold deeper. One more deep breath all the way in. Exhale. And then on the next inhale, you're going to take a big step back with your left foot into a high or low lunge, yogi's choice. Roll those shoulders back and down, eye goes forward. Take a nice deep breath all the way in. Exhale. One more deep breath all the way in again. Exhale, step back to your down facing dog. We're here for three breaths, so feel free to pedal out through the feet as it's the first one of the day. Remember to spread your fingers, press the chest through the arms. Release that neck from your shoulders. So broaden the upper back, rotate the shoulders outwards or the elbows inwards so that you create a broader upper back. Take a nice deep breath all the way in. Exhale, push the heels towards the floor. And on the next inhale, roll forwards to high plank. Option to drop the knees if you need to. Exhale, low plank or knees, chest, chin. And then inhale as you press up to Sphinx on the elbows for a slightly lesser back bend or cobra. Squeeze the glutes, point the toes, squeeze the inner thighs, support that lower back. And then when you're ready, exhale, tuck the toes and press back to down facing dog. This time you can pulse through the shoulders if you want to, pressing the chest through the arms toward the floor. Or you can continue with that pedaling through the feet. Yogi's choice. On the next inhale, you're going to step through with the left foot into that high or low lunge, rolling the shoulders up and down. Eye gaze forwards, chest comes through the arms. Take a nice deep breath all the way in. Exhale, one more deep breath all the way in again. Exhale, step through to your Uttanasana, forward fold. Again, you're here for three deep breaths, so you can either do that inhale and exhale to lift and lengthen, or take the opposite hands to opposite elbows and just gently rock from side to side. Opening up the lower back, the glutes, the hips. One more deep breath all the way in. Exhale and then inhale as you come all the way up. Extended Tadasana. Exhale, we're gonna swan dive straight back down. So round two, we're at two breaths per pose. Inhale to find length. Exhale to fold deeper. And then inhale as you step back with your right foot this time into your high or low lunge, yogi's choice. Roll those shoulders back and down. Eye gaze forwards, chest comes through the arms. Take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, step back to your down facing dog. Inhale, find length in the spine. Exhale, push the heels toward the floor. And then when you're ready, inhale as you roll forwards to your high plank. Option to drop the knees, remember if you need to. Exhale, low plank or knees, chest, chin. Inhale, press up to cobra. And then exhale as you tuck the toes and press back to your down facing dog. Take a nice deep breath in, find length in the spine. Exhale, push the heels towards the floor. And then as you inhale again, step your right foot through into that high or low lunge. Roll those shoulders back and down. Take a nice deep breath all the way in. Exhale, step through to your Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale to find length, exhale to fold deeper. And then inhale as we come all the way up, extended Tadasana. So the last two rounds, we're gonna do one breath per pose. So if you get lost, just move and breathe. Exhale, come down into your Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, left foot goes back, high or low lunge. Exhale, right foot goes back, down facing dog. Inhale to roll forwards to high plank. Exhale, low plank or knees, chest, chin. Inhale, press up to cobra. Exhale, tuck the toes and press back to down facing dog. Inhale, left foot comes through, high or low lunge. Exhale, right foot comes through, Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, lift all the way up, extended Tadasana. Exhale as you swan dive back down for your fourth and final round. Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, right foot goes back, high or low lunge. Exhale, left foot goes back, down facing dog. Inhale, roll forwards to high plank. Exhale, low plank or knees, chest, chin. Inhale, press up to Sphinx or Cobra. Exhale as you tuck the toes and press back to your down facing dog. Take a nice deep breath all the way in and step through with that right foot into your high or low lunge. Exhale, step through to Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, lift all the way up, extend to Tadasana. Exhale, release, reset, shake it all out. And then we're gonna move down to that sideways and set up on our mats. So we're gonna start off with a seated wide leg forward fold. So you're gonna come onto your mats, find yourself in a seated position. I'm gonna take the legs out nice and wide. So really think about your setup here. We're flexing the toes back towards us, so you're almost pushing the heels away from you, and you're thinking about getting the fleshy bits out from underneath your sit bones, so both sit bones are connected to the floor. You're not sat wonky, you're nice and balanced on either side. From here, slowly ease your legs out as far as you feel comfortable, and when you're ready, we're going to inhale to lift and lengthen, just like a regular forward fold, and then exhale as you reach forwards. Think about more chest towards the floor rather than crunching the neck down and trying to get your head towards the floor. And we're just gonna take five pulses, reaching through the legs, exhaling to reach further, inhaling to come back up. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5. From here, we're just going to inhale to come all the way up, and then exhale to reach down that left leg. Inhale to come all the way back up again, and then exhale to reach down that right leg. We're gonna do 3 of these each side. So just moving with your own breath in your own time. Just slowly getting into the backs of those legs. Last one each way. And then come all the way back to center. This time, inhale to lift and reach again. Exhale to fold forwards. And we're gonna do 3 each side, but we're gonna go from side to side with the hands. So exhale as you reach over to the left. Inhale as you come back through center. Exhale to reach over to the right. Inhale back to center. Exhale. So you're just sweeping from side to side 3 times on each leg. Last one, and then come all the way back up to center. From here, we're gonna take the right hand back behind us, keeping our legs exactly where they are. You're gonna think about rocking over and pressing the feet into the floor. So you're gonna lift the hips up, left hand is gonna go up towards the ceiling, and you're gonna reach over the right side into a kind of wide leg back bend. Exhale, release, and then switch sides. So left hand goes behind, inhale to lift and reach, with the right hand up towards the ceiling. Exhale, release. We're just going to do 3 each side. So just moving with your own breath, in your own time, lifting and reaching, opening up those hip flexors, of course, opening up the backs of the legs, opening up the thoracic spine and the chest. The last one each way. And then come all the way back down to a seated position on your mat. From here, you're then going to come into cow face lick. So we're gonna work into this. If you're not there yet, don't worry, I'll give you plenty of options. So we're gonna take the right leg underneath, bending the knee, and bringing it straight out in front of you. The left leg is gonna cross and stack over the top. So a good way to get into this is to come up onto your hands and knees, crisscross the legs with the right leg behind, and then sit back into your cow face position. So, knees should be stacked directly on top of each other and sit bones should be on the floor. If this isn't allowed, if your hips aren't allowing you to get here yet, don't worry, just take that top leg, place the foot on the floor, and we're just simply gonna come into that half lord of a fish's stretch. If you are able to get there, I'm gonna readjust myself, and you feel like you're comfortably sat with both sit bones on the floor, we're gonna take another forward fold. So you're going to inhale to lift and reach, and then exhale as you come over those legs. Hold for 5,
4, 3, 2, 1. And then inhale as you come all the way back up. We're going to unravel the legs and then you're going to crisscross them the other way. So right leg is going to go over, left leg's going to go under. So if you need to come back up, come into that kneeling position and then sit back down, you can. Remember, there's always that half lord or the fishes option. Just make sure that both sit bones are connected to the floor. If you also struggle with the half lord or the fishes option with both sit bones connected, you can extend that lower leg too, don't forget. So once you're set up, find yourself in that nice double sit bone on the floor position and then inhale to lift and reach, exhale to fold over the legs. Let the head just rest on the knees and then hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale as you come all the way back up and then we're going to take the legs back out to that wide leg position again. So from there, we're then going to take the foot in towards, so the right foot in towards the left thigh. And then you're going to take your left hand, your right hand, sorry, back behind you as you lift and reach with the left hand. We're going to be able to go slightly further over this time. So this is rock star pose. You're going to reach all the way over as far as you can. Take a nice deep breath in. Exhale. And then as we inhale, we're going to come all the way up, sweeping the arms. So you're going to sweep the arm around the floor in like a semicircle, coming up into a kneeling position and then reaching over into half gate pose. So you've gone from rock star to half gate. And then from here, you're going to sit back as you exhale into half head to knee pose. And then we're going to do all three movements again, three more times or four more times. So five times in total. So you're going to inhale as you windmill the arms up and back, right hand to the floor, left hand reaches up, hips go up, find that back bend. As you exhale, sweep the hands, circling them around the floor, and then inhale to come up into that half gate pose. Exhale to come down into half head to knee pose. Three more times. So just move with your own breath, windmilling the arms up and over, coming into that rock star, sweeping the arms around. So think about making a circle with the arms as you inhale to lift and reach, and then exhale to fold, lower, whatever you need to do. Two more times, you're doing really well. So inhale to lift and reach, rock star. Exhale, circle the arms. Inhale to lift, exhale to reach, and then lower. Last time through. And of course, we're gonna do this, if you hadn't guessed already, on the other side. So when you've done that last one, simply come down, hold that last hold for just a moment, and then inhale as you come back up to center and reset the legs back to that seated wide leg position. Brilliant. So set yourself up again in that seated wide leg position. This time, left foot comes in towards the inner right thigh, right leg remains extended. Again, we're going to take that left hand behind us. Inhale to lift and reach into that rock star position, and then sweeping the arms around in a circle, coming through to that half gate pose. Exhale, come down into your forward fold, half head to knee pose. And you're doing that four more times. So windmill the arms all the way up. Rock star. Sweep round to half gate. Exhale as you come down into half head to knee pose. Inhale, windmill the arms up and over. Reach back to rock star. Sweep the arms all the way round. Half gate. Exhale. Half head to knee pose. Two more times. Windmill all the way up. Rock star. Exhale, sweep into gate. Exhale into half head to knee pose. Last time through. Windmill all the way up. Rock star. Sweep into gate. And then exhale as you sit back into your half head to knee pose. When you're there, just inhale to come all the way back to center, and then take your hands to the front two corners of the mat. We're going to come back to our down facing dog position. So taking the hands to the front two corners of the mat, tuck the toes, press back and up into down facing dog. We're going to come into scorpion pose and pigeon pose. So you're going to inhale as you lift that right leg up high to the sky, three leg down facing dog, bend at the knee, open up that hip, and then bring that right knee through to the front right corner of the mat. Slide the left leg back, find your nice seated upright pigeon, take a nice deep breath all the way in, and then exhale as you lower over that leg. Option to stay here for three deep breaths, or you can take the hands back behind you, using your body weight to inhale to lift, and then exhale to lower. Just three times. When you've done those three times, everybody come back to that sleeping pigeon. Hands go underneath the shoulders, step back to your down facing dog, and then we're gonna take a vinyasa. So we're going to inhale as we roll forwards to high plank, exhale, low plank or knees, chest, chin, and then inhale as we press up to cobra. From here, we're gonna melt the body back down as we exhale, finding ourselves in a prone position, and we're gonna work into our bow variations. So option one, you can just simply practice your locust lifts, taking chest and thighs off the floor. Option two, you can take same hand back to same foot and do half bow, inhaling to lift and kick, half lotus, half bow. Exhale, release. You can then switch sides, practice with the other foot, and then hold, and then you're going to take for full bow, for those of you that want to, both hands back to same side feet, and then when you're ready, keeping the knees as close together as possible, you're going to inhale as you lift and kick back into the hands, taking that chest off the floor, really pushing through the feet to lift the body higher. Take a nice deep breath in, and then exhale to lower. From here, take the hands back underneath, press back to your extended child's pose. Take a nice deep breath all the way in. Exhale. And then we will repeat on the other side. So slowly come back up onto your hands and knees. Tuck the toes, press back into your down facing dog position. From here, left leg now goes high to the sky. Find that scorpion hip twist, opening up that hip, opening up that hip flexor. And then when you're ready, bring that knee through to the front left corner of the mat. Slide the right leg back. Set yourself up in that nice level hip position. Inhale as you press the ground away, feel the stretch in the hip flexor. And then exhale to melt the body forwards. Remember, two options here, to stay here for three deep breaths, or you can inhale to lift and exhale to lower three times instead. Using your body weight, moving from your glute and hip stretch into more of a hip flexor stretch on the other leg, last one. When you've done those three, bring the hands back underneath your shoulders, find yourself in that sleeping pigeon position, and then we're stepping back to that down facing dog and taking another vinyasa. So you're going to inhale to roll forwards to high plank, exhale low plank or knees, chest, chin. Inhale, press up to cobra, and then exhale as you melt the body forwards. We're back to that bow. So option, again, you've got your locust lift, your half bows, or your full bows. So pick whichever progression you'd like to do. If you're doing half bow, make sure you do equal reps on both sides. And with full bow, just have a practice of lifting and lowering. So we're going to inhale to lift and kick. See if you can hold, really kick back into the feet, and then exhale to lower. Again, inhale to lift and kick. See if you can hold, and then exhale to lower. We'll just do one more for the full bow. If you've got the half bow, do one more on each side. Inhale to lift and kick. For the full bow, see if you can hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then exhale, release, and come back with your hands underneath your shoulders and press back to your extended child's pose. Take a nice deep breath in, exhale, and then slowly tuck the toes, come up onto your hands and knees, walk the feet all the way in towards the hands, coming into your Uttanasana, forward fold at the front of the mat, and then inhale as you come all the way up, extended Tadasana, exhale, release, reset. So well done, girls, that was quite a different workout from before. We've just got one little bit of balance before we're gonna move down onto the floor. So today's balance sequence is a knee raise to forward fold, grabbing your fingers around your toe or your knee, coming up into a hand, big toe pose, and then taking it back to warrior three or dancers. So I'll demonstrate it to you and then you can have a go. So we're gonna start in Tadasana. You're going to inhale to lift the hands up and the knee towards the chest. So if you need to, take a hold of a wall, a door, a chair, whatever you need, and then see if you can hold that knee either with your hand or keep your hands lifted, so use some strength. You're then going to exhale as you come into a forward fold, extending that leg forwards and folding nose towards toes. Option to go back to that knee raised up, or take your two big fingers, hook them around your big toe, and then you're going to inhale to lift and come up into hand big toe pose. Hold for just a moment, then you're going to release that foot and then take it all the way back behind you. Find your warrior three, hold for just a moment more, and if you want to, see if you can come back into dancer's pose. Hold again and then relax as you exhale. So make sure you do both sides. I'll guide you through it. We'll do it together, but if you're not keeping up or you're going a little bit faster, don't worry. So we're gonna move our weight over onto our right leg to start. You're going to inhale as you lift hands and left knee up towards your chest. Hold for 3, 2, 1, then exhale as you fold, extending that leg straight out in front of you, reaching nose towards toes. Again, you're gonna take your fingers around your big toe or hand around your knee, and then you're going to inhale as you lift up, hand to big toe pose. Oops. Hold if you can. And then when you're ready, release that hand. See if you can keep that leg lifted and then take it all the way back behind you. And exhale, come into your warrior three. Hold again for 3, 2, 1, and then option to take the same hand back to inside of that foot, lift and kick into dancers. And again, hold for 3, 2, 1, exhale, release. We're gonna switch sides. So come back to your Tadasana, reset, catch your breath if you've been holding it the whole time probably. And then you're gonna come onto your left foot this time. So your left leg is your standing leg. You're going to inhale as you lift right knee off the floor, taking the hands up above you. Remember, you can hold that right knee if you need to. As you exhale, fold down into that forward fold with the extended leg, reaching nose towards toes. And then fingers go around big toe, or you're lifting around that knee, and you're going to inhale to lift up into hand to big toe pose. Hold, if you can, for 3, 2, 1, then release the hand. See if you can keep that leg lifted, and then take that leg all the way back behind you. Come into your warrior three. And again, hold for 3, 2, 1. Same hand goes back to same foot, inside edge of the foot, remember. And then inhale to lift and kick into dancers. Hold again for 3, 2, 1. And then exhale, release, reset. And we're gonna come down to the floor for some simple stretches to finish and cool down. So coming down into your seated position on your mats. We're coming into our regular seated forward fold. So bringing the fleshy bits of your bum out from underneath you. Inhale as you lift and lengthen, reaching up tall, and then exhale as you fold forwards. Take 5 deep breaths. Last deep breath all the way in. Exhale. And then slowly inhale as you come all the way back up seated. Taking the hands back behind you, take the fingertips pointing away from you. Roll the shoulders back and down. Think about lifting through the heart towards the ceiling. Take the eye gaze up. Take a nice deep breath in. If this is enough for you, stay here. If you want to, you can extend or deepen the stretch by scooting the bum towards the heels, keeping that lift through the chest. You should feel this across the chest, into the shoulders, and maybe now down into your arms. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Scoot the bum back out towards the hands, and then release the arms, shake them out. We're gonna come into half Lord of the Fishes. So option one, the underneath leg can stay extended. So my right leg's gonna stay extended, left foot's gonna go over the top. Option two, you're gonna hook that right knee or right leg around you so that the sole of the foot is facing upwards outside of your left hip. Make sure whichever position you're in, both sit bones are connected. You're then gonna grab the knee with the hand or the elbow of the right arm, twisting the tummy in towards the thigh. Inhaling to lift, exhaling to look over that left shoulder. Three deep breaths. Last deep breath all the way in. Exhale, unravel the body, unravel the legs, and then we're gonna switch sides. So left leg is gonna go under or extended. Right foot is gonna come over the top of the knee and place on the floor outside. Both sit bones are connected to the floor. Hooking the hand or the elbow around that right knee. Inhale to lift and twist tummy to thigh. Exhale as you look over your right shoulder. Sorry. Hold for 3 deep breaths. Last deep breath all the way in. Exhale. And then slowly unravel yourself. Unravel your legs. Slide your bum down towards your heels and come onto your backs. Bringing your knees in towards your chest, just gently rock from side to side. Massage your lower back into the ground. And then when you're ready, you're gonna take the arms out wide in a T-shaped position, palms facing down. As you exhale, you're gonna drop the knees all the way over to the left. And as you inhale, you're gonna twist your head to look all the way over to the right. Option to let gravity do the work. Press down on the outer thigh or extend that top leg and cradle it in the opposite hand, yogi's choice. 5 deep breaths. Exhale completely on that last deep breath. And then slowly inhale as you lift head and knees back to center and switch sides. So knees drop all the way over to the right as you exhale. Inhale to lift and twist the head toward the left. Press down on that outer thigh, extend that top leg or let gravity do the work. Yogi's choice. And again, hold for 5 deep breaths. Last deep breath all the way in. Exhale. And then slowly inhale as you bring knees and head back to center. Hug the knees in tight just one last time. Enjoy that gentle massage of the lower back.
And then whenever you're ready, just gently make your way all the way up to seated, finding yourself in the center of your mat. We'll take one final deep inhale as we lift the hands up above the head, palms together at the top. And as we exhale, bringing the hands to the forehead, kind thoughts to the lips, kind words to the heart, kind feelings. Namaste.